Muy buenas chicos, ¿cómo están? Sean bienvenidos, yo soy Amigo Bill, estamos en otro capítulo más de Genshin Impact y como siempre, si bien esta vez no pude hacer el live completo en vivo, pues sí que se lo voy a grabar y lo vamos a ver en vivo. No he visto ninguna parte del video, así que vamos a vernos, pues bueno, unos 20-30 minutitos del directo y veremos qué sale. En este caso, los códigos, pues bueno, como siempre los voy a dejar abajito en la descripción del video, si es que siguen funcionando, si no, no pasa nada, ¿vale? Recuerden que estos los pudieron haber cambiado al inicio de hoy de la mañana, hasta las 12 del día, normalmente que es lo que se cambia, y estaremos viendo, pues bueno, qué nos van a presentar. ¿Qué tengo fe de que nos pueda presentar? Obviamente, Emily. Obviamente, el nuevo mapa. Obviamente, lo que vamos a hacer en el nuevo mapa. Supongo que algún nuevo personaje que nos presente alguna mecánica nueva dentro de la 4.8 para obviamente la 5.0. Y al parecer por ahí se filtraron algunos personajes. Vi uno amarillito y uno azulito y uno verdecito, pero no sé muy bien de qué va el rollo. Vi algo montadito en un carrito, pero vamos a ver cómo va el asunto. Así que venga, vamos a vernos de directo y que sea lo que tenga que ser. Al final es un mapa nuevo. Protogemas para nuevos personajes, así que venga, vamos a darle.
Hello travelers, welcome to the version 4.8
okay,
special
Emily,
program.
Okay, Emily, Najide, iba a decir esta.
I'm Sarah Miller Cruz, the voice of the female Milo traveler.
Kirara, ¿no? Ya
before
ya sabíamos
get the ball
que venían.
Rolling, let's introduce our other hosts.
Yay! Hello everyone, my name is Amber Aviles and I voice Emily, a famous perfumer from Fontaine.
Hey guys, my name is Danny Chambers, and I'm the voice of Nilu, a talented dancer from Sumeru.
Yeah!
And I'm Julia Gu, the voice of Kirara, a courier from Inazuma.
Oh my gosh, amazing! So I am so happy to have you guys here. Okay, y'all can probably guess why we're all here today. It's time for us to show off a new limited-time summer map.
Ooh.
I can't wait to see what the developers have been cooking up this time. Yes. I haven't even seen the final version.
Ooh. Well, that's what the version 4.8 trailer is for. Let's take a look.
Woohoo!
Yes!
Port Oromos is currently organizing a flower exhibition.
That strange smell around here.
Surround yourself with fragrance for too long, and your sense of smell will become dull. Allow yourself to be consumed by your emotions, and you lose the ability to think rationally.
I'm Emily, a perfumer from Fontaine.
Me encanta.
Reconstitute! This will brighten up the place!
Lo único que no me gusta es su cabello corto.
The hero from another world, supported by their companions, shall restore peace to the world.
Chubby paper hamster just talked.
Son de juguete, ¿no?
Morning. Huh?
It wasn't just a dream?
But this Nekomata friend of yours, she doesn't eat hamsters, does she?
I remember I was reading a book at the Grand Bazaar. Well, then I woke up dressed like this.
Está fea la ropa
de loco. Like to ride a toy train.
You're really easy to please, Navia.
Choo-choo! Aerial Express moving out.
Ooh, that's an adventure and a half. Do all storybook heroes have to work this hard?
If you actually expect me to answer them all, we'll be here until the next Inter-Darshan Championship. To find the dragon responsible for this whole mess.
Cristóbal Gamer dice, la encontraste fea.
Yo la vi fea. Me gustó más la de Kirara, está más bonita.
Introduce everyone to one of Fontaine's
Segway, of course, of our new character.
Sinceramente no me pareció bonita, me gustó más la de Kirara. Es más una copia de Navia.
Wow, this is making me feel super ready for some summer adventures.
So, this is probably the perfect place to show off our new character.
Yes! Oh my gosh. That was the perfect segue.
A perfect segue, of course.
Yes, yes. All right, let's introduce everyone to one of Fontaine's most renowned perfumers, Emily.
Woo! Mm. Oh, Emily isn't just a great perfumer. She's also a pharmacology and botany expert.
Oh, wait. That reminds me. Doesn't one of Chloran's voice lines mention that Emily has a true profession, an identity that stayed a mystery up till now?
We'll know once we've learned more about her. A casual stroll after a meal aids digestion and increases blood circulation. So, would you like to join?
Siempre usan la misma canción para presentar los personajes.
Fresh and floral.
Oh my gosh.
What? Oh my gosh.
She's so cool.
Right? I love her shoes.
Yes. So cool. And did you see when she smelled the perfume? Oh my gosh, I absolutely love that detail.
Yeah. Yes, she's so elegant, like just the way she moves. Like it's just so beautiful.
Yes.
I know, right? So let me tell you, Emily is the most renowned perfumer in Fontaine.
Ooh.
The new products that she releases usually sell out immediately.
What?
Well, almost. So if you want to get your hands on one of her perfumes, then be prepared to start lining up at 4 in the morning.
Oh.
Whoa.
Mm.
Emily has another identity on top of her trade as a perfumer. She's a forensic cleaner.
Huh.
Mm-hmm. She's the one who cleans up crime scenes after an investigation has been concluded. She's a very experienced cleaner, so she often picks up details and scraps of evidence that other people overlooked.
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
Oh, okay. So she's kind of like a forensic examiner.
Así es.
Chevres mentioned it in one of her voice lines. She said that Emily's chemistry knowledge is super helpful for uncovering hidden clues during investigations. She can tell what type of perfume that someone wears and where they've been spending time. Okay, it all makes sense now. It's because of her forensics work. That also explains how Emily and Chevres got so close.
Uh-huh, absolutely. Forensic cleaning is a lot more dangerous than creating perfumes.
Hmm.
Emily generally doesn't talk about her other identity in order to avoid retaliation from suspects.
Hmm.
So most people only know her as a famous perfumer.
Oh, Emily's probably been through all sorts of stressful situations.
You're right.
From like high-end venues to gruesome crime scenes.
Ugh.
Oof, it must take a lot of mental toughness to handle all that.
Yeah.
Exactly. And her professional experiences contribute to her unique combat style. Emily is a dendropole arm user. When she unleashes her elemental skill, she creates a Lumidus case that deals AoE dendro damage.
Ooh, I bet that skill releases a really nice fragrance.
Mm.
I know. The Lumidus case is a creation that Emily is really proud of.
Oh.
It fires puffs of pure dew at nearby opponents periodically, which deals dendro damage.
Oh.
When nearby opponents are affected by the burning reaction, the Lumidus case will accumulate scents at intervals.
Oh.
I know, right? After collecting 2 scents, the Lumidus case will be upgraded from level 1 to level 2.
Oh.
At level 2, the Lumidus case can fire an extra puff of pure dew.
Oh.
The damage dealt by the puffs of pure dew will also be increased. Only 1 Lumidus case created by Emily can exist at a time.
Oh, wait, does that mean it's pointless to collect scents once you've already reached level 2, though?
Oh, no, not at all. After Emily's passive talent, lingering fragrance has been unlocked.
Hmm.
The level 2 Lumidus case will release Clear Dew Cologne that scales with every 2 scents collected.
Oh.
The cologne will deal AoE dendro damage to nearby opponents.
Okay. So if I'm understanding this correctly, only enemies under the burning status will create scents, and the damage scales with the number of scents collected by the Lumidus case?
Exactly. That sums it up perfectly.
Oh.
After unlocking one of her specific talents, Emily will deal greater damage to enemies under the burning condition.
Oh.
And when a Lumidus case is on the field, it increases the entire party's resistance to burning damage.
Oh, okay. Now I understand how Emily's talents can work in a party. So, once you use her Lumidus case to apply Dendro to your enemies, you can use a Pyro skill with a different character to trigger the burning condition.
Uh-huh, that's exactly right.
Okay.
And the Lumidus case has even more functionalities.
Oh.
After you've unleashed Emily's Elemental Burst, the Lumidus case will rise to level 3 and collect the existing Lumidus case on the field.
Oh, that's cool.
This fully upgraded Lumidus case will cause Scented Dew to continuously descend onto nearby enemies, dealing Dendro damage.
Yeah.
When the level 3 Lumidus case leaves the field, a new Lumidus case will be created. This case will be at the same level as the one she collected during her burst.
Okay, so if a level 2 Lumidus case is about to leave the field, then you could unleash Emily's Elemental Burst to reset its duration. That way the level 2 Lumidus case will be able to spend even more time on the field.
Bingo! It seems like you've really figured out her kit. But we should let travelers experiment with these mechanics for themselves.
Okay, I think I understand Emily a lot better now that we've learned about her skills.
Mm.
She transforms scents into perfumes and leaves the world a cleaner place.
Yes.
Honestly, her skills seem to perfectly combine her talents as both a perfumer and forensic cleaner.
Mm. Yeah. Right? Exactly.
Okay, great.
Emily is an expert with all kinds of scents. No suspect can hope to remain in the shadows while Emily is on the case. She always manages to discover the truth.
Ooh, are we gonna get the chance to see her forensic cleaner side? Please say yes.
Please. Oh, absolutely.
Yes.
During Emily's story quest, the Pomum de Ombra chapter, travelers will learn about the mysterious Agus flower that has appeared in Sumeru. Travelers will work with Emily to uncover a series of mysteries related to this flower and expose the truth once and for all.
Ooh, so exciting!
I love mysteries.
I know. You'll have to leave travelers to uncover the details for themselves. In the meantime, I have some other information.
Eso que limpiara escenas del crimen me pareció interesante.
Sí, sí, está bastante bien. Creo que sí está bien.
In the first phase of version 4.8,
vale,
travelers
Navia,
look forward to returning
Nilou.
Event wishes from Navia and Nilou. Be sure to check them out if you're interested.
And in the second phase of version 4.8,
we'll have madre, event wishes for Emily and parte, Nayla.
A new 5-star polearm, Lumidus Elegy, will also be featured on the weapon banner.
All right, okay. That was a lot of information just now, so let's take a break for my sake.
Yeah, that sounds good. It's also the right time to show the second redemption code anyway.
Yay!
Okay, we will see you soon, travelers.
Yes.
Toodles.
Nice. Oh, it looks like we're headed to a new place.
And if we're headed to a beautiful location, then it's only fitting to wear a beautiful outfit.
Yes, exactly. You are so right. And Nilou and Kirara will get new outfits in version 4.8.
Yes!
Oh, I'm so excited.
I'm so ready. So ready. Oh, okay. Let's start off with Nilou. I took a good look earlier, and I have to say, it's totally awesome. I have to share it with y'all in more detail. Okay, take a look.
Es como una princesa. Intentaron vestirla como una princesa, por lo que estoy entendiendo.
I present to you a gift from the forest.
Sí, es que la intentaron vestir como una princesa, pero
oh,
o sea, no
gosh,
queda pues por su
so
normal canon. Bienvenido al árbol de Birk. Norman Cannon. Dice, buenas noches. El hexano ubicado. Bienvenido al árbol de Birk. El hexano ubicado. Dice, saludos. Ya voy ahorrando mis euros para la skin de Nilou. Por fin podrá bailar en el agua sin mojarse los zapatos.
Jesús Oliver.
Pero sin Nilou nunca llevaba zapatos, ¿no?
Black como una bailarina de baile.
Tales, right?
Cristóbal Gamer.
Yeah.
Dice,
cool.
A mí la verdad para ser de 4 estrellas
summer,
me pareció buena.
Cristóbal
Gamer.
Known as
dice,
In this world, Nilu would get a new outfit and a new identity.
That is so exciting.
Awesome.
Yes. It's going to be so good.
So, I'm guessing Simulanka is the new summer region?
Yep. And this fairy tale world is facing all sorts of crises. Travelers will discover a giant footprint shortly after entering this world.
Thanks for subscribing.
A darle, chicos. Perdón que les paré el video, chicos, porque...
Wait a second.
Right?
You'd have to be massive to leave a footprint like that.
Mm-hmm. Oh, absolutely. Oh, and if you follow the footprints into the depths of the region, then you might be able to find some clues. Origami animals live in this forest, so you might be able to get some valuable information from them.
Ooh.
That's helpful.
Mm-hmm. Huh. I noticed some of the animals look off color.
Yes, they do. Very perceptive of you. Some of the origami animals are in big trouble. The color of their paper is fading. I know, and it's so sad. So travelers will need to work together with their friends to revitalize the forest and help those animals solve this crisis.
Oh my gosh. Mm-hmm. I will do anything to help these origami creatures. I love them already.
I know. I want to take one home with me.
Yes, but okay. Travelers won't have to face these crises alone. They'll receive help from all sorts of companions during their journey in Simulanka.
Hey, it's Kirara in her new outfit. And Navia!
Yes.
Oh, and there's Hat Guy.
Don't jump
in. If travelers are interested in seeing how the events in Simulanka unfold, then be sure to check out the summer region during the new update.
Okay, well, since Kirara is wearing her cool new outfit, can we take a closer look?
Thank you, Mew, for noticing. That's just what I've been waiting for.
Lo que me gusta, yes. Me parece más sexy el de Kirara aún.
Scaling walls, leaping across the rooftops. Nothing new for me.
Mira, uff, qué guapo, está sexy, bo. Botita, cortita la faldita, bo. Digo, un chortito porque.
Like
mira ese culazo, bo. Y trae su sombrerito, está guapo, bo.
She's so cool. It looks like she's ready for an adventure.
Hat.
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah, the color, style, and the accessories all compliment Kirara perfectly. She's really giving me like a strong impression of a vigilante who comes out at night. You know what I'm talking about?
You better watch out.
Dice,
best of all, pura excusa mejor di que te gustan los fierros XD. Excerpts of Bliss will be scattered throughout the world. Travelers will need to collect jubilant feathers and open fairy tale trolls to obtain excerpts of Bliss. After you've collected enough of these excerpts, travelers can obtain Kirara's new outfit for free. Plus, they can also get Primo Gems and other rewards.
Yes! Oh, awesome! I know what I'm doing the minute 4.8 goes live. Collecting excerpts of Bliss so I can get my hands on that outfit.
Oh, heck yeah. Getting my paws on that.
Yeah, you can definitely count me in. I love it.
Cristo Valgamer.
There's so much to do in the new version.
You think
XD, so? Tengo evidencia
well,
del Dragon's
there's
Dogma
even
XD.
More content in the big
el
summer
no
update.
Ubicar.
No. Yes, there's
dice.
More.
Pero si su skin es un calco de la de Navia, confiesa,
oh, really?
Te gustan sus pezuñas de gata.
Oh, you got it. Travelers can look forward to four different
dice,
kinds of gameplay in
Simulanka. Hay una serpiente en mi bota, jajaja.
The first is called Boreal Flurry. Travelers will have to move through streaming currents and destroy targets to score points and earn rewards. Destroying special targets will even produce unique effects. I really, really,
ese ya
really
lo jugamos
love
ese evento.
More,
igual fue
we'll
la 3.8.
Experiment with them in the game.
O sea, reciclaron
oh
el evento.
This is so cool. It's like we get to shoot at things mid-air. That's awesome.
Yeah, right? So cool. Oh, okay, next up, we have Flying Hatter's Trick. Travelers can use a flying hat to attract toy figures, allowing them to score points in a variety of different game modes.
Oh, hey, it looks like a claw machine, just like the ones in the arcades.
Yes.
Oh.
Exactly. I am still terrible with those, though.
You're
going to
be good at this, though. I can
I hope so. I hope so. Thank you for your belief in me.
Always.
The third gameplay is called Metropole Trials. Travelers will need to form two teams to complete a combat trial. Defeating opponents will accumulate valor. Filling your Valor Energy bar will trigger a Time for Valor, which grants buffs to your team.
Oh, nice.
Defeating opponents while a Time for Valor is active will earn you
bienvenido
even more
al árbol
points.
De Virv.
Oh, un evento reciclado, reciclando el del sombrero. Events,
earn Star Seal coins. Hola. In figurine fabrication, travelers can insert these coins into fantastical fabricators to earn keepsake figurines. Mm-hmm. Hopefully that makes it even easier for travelers to remember their journey.
Aww, Jesús what a Olivero cute origami hamster.
Dice,
so cute.
La llegó tu
just
momento, Deja con Emily. Ufadidu. Dice, ¿cómo estás?
After travelers bien, bien. Have used the fantastical fabricators enough times, they'll be able to invite Kirara to their team and claim special rewards, including Prima Gems and Serenity Pot furnishings.
Oh, and travelers can display their figurines on good frames, both inside their Serenity Pot and around Simulanka. But don't worry if you don't receive the figurine that you want. You can also gift and trade figurines with your friends! Yes!
Relief. That's
awesome. Yes.
So cool. It sounds like the summer region gives us a lot to look forward to.
Mm-hmm.
I wonder what else version 4.8 has in store.
Vale, nos van a dar la skin y la gata.
Oh, okay.
Bastante bueno el evento.
Timing. All right, let's take a look at the rest of the events in version 4.8.
All right.
Yes. Oh, first up, we're introducing the Imaginarium Theater. A once-blank canvas has been sitting in a corner of the theater lobby, but now, vibrant colors have emerged on its surface. This new permanent gameplay mode will launch in version 4.8.
Nice!
5 Envisaged Echoes challenges will become available in version 4.8. Each challenge will correspond to a designated character. Travelers will receive 2 keys of Echoes upon entering the challenge, and each challenge requires 2 keys to unlock.
Jesús Olivero.
If you complete the challenge,
dice,
then you'll be able to obtain the
Black,
corresponding
pero últimamente están haciendo,
reward.
Haciendo así. Regalan la skin y una copia.
Ah, ya sé qué cosa es lo del caminar y esa madre.
They'll have a unique trailing effect while they're sprinting.
Oh my gosh. Diluc's echo looks like flaming feathers.
Cristóbal va por Diluc
so cool.
Y ya le chupa el huevo a Diluc
yes,
en todo. Yo voy por mi Kikibo.
To give her ghost companion.
Kiki, ahí te voy.
Honestly, I feel like that's something that Hu Tao would be super interested in.
Chichi Run,
right?
Run, Chichi Run.
Dice, hold on. I have a question.
¿Para qué es Black?
If we only start
eso, solamente es un visual que le pusieron al personaje cuando camina.
Right?
Jesús Olivero.
Are there any other dice, ways to obtain those
yo
keys?
Voy por Millán.
Oh, yeah, of course.
Yo voy por Millán y Kira, nada más seguro.
Dice,
each season of the Imaginarium no Theater, where they complete and finalize a combat performance in Act 6 or higher.
Oh, okay, so you can't unlock those Echo rewards in one go.
Aw, Drac.
Yes, exactly. I know. So take your time, everyone. There's no need to rush. It's not going anywhere. Oh, by the way, you can only complete the challenge using its designated character. You're also going to have to pay attention to the character level and friendship level requirements.
Ooh,
the participation
no
character
la gente.
Must be level 90,
dice,
and their friendship
Black,
level
pero
must
si
be
no
8
tienes
or higher.
Un personaje
it's
de
time
esos,
to test out well you truly know your characters. Sweet.
Cuidado, que tiene restricciones.
Así
the
no,
Envisaged
Black.
Echoes challenge doesn't just test how well you can use a character, but also how well you understand their skills. Each challenge has specific obstacles, and you'll only be able to pass if you fully master the character's skill mechanics.
Huh. That's awesome! Oh man, I'm so excited.
Te pide que seas nivel 8
so
de amistad y nivel 90 de personaje.
To a ton of events happening in Fontaine.
Yeah.
Travelers will get to meet an enthusiastic scholar in Romaritime Harbor, which allows travelers to play Bing Bang Finchball. Thanks, Basima.
Basima and Finchball seems to remind me of something. Oh, wait. Wasn't there also a Basima in version 3.8?
Oh.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, that's right. The Basima we met last year was a Hydro-Idolan replica of a human who once
dice,
visited the Valeria Mirage
sabía
5
que
centuries
no era
ago.
Tan sencillo.
She invented the earliest version of Finchball.
Pues yo tengo
Basima
todo mi personaje con,
is her descendant.
Con bastante... Oh. Ese, bueno, Kirara no sé, pero
a
mi personaje casi todo lo tengo con... Con
and
amistad
since
alta.
So much time has passed, I'm guessing that we'll get to experience a new kind of Finchball.
Exactly. Travelers will still need to launch Finchballs into target zones in order to score points. But these new stages will have
Jesús
rival
Olivero.
Finchballs.
Te digo que reciclaron el evento con
points,
Black.
So travelers will need to strategize based on the situation in front of them.
Ooh, oh. I like the new changes. Mm. I'm excited to try the new Finchball.
And that's not the only new addition. This version also has a co-op mode.
What?
So
let's
you
go.
Can be each other's rival. Finch balls. Yes.
Oh, vamos a poder jugar que te voy a hacer mierda.
Can freely choose their level while they're in co-op mode. Each level has different terrain characteristics and types of Finch balls. Players will take turns launching Finch balls, and the person with the most points after four rounds will win the match.
That sounds really fun, no matter who wins or loses.
Totally. I mean, look at these little guys, look at the little finches, they're so cute!
Cristo Valdamer dice,
so
tantos eventos reciclados que hasta la Live parece reciclado XD.
De hecho, parece reciclado.
Que... Dice, Black, te reto a una partida de esas.
Cuando salga,
a Siguri has made her way to Fontaine, but this time, her photo requirements aren't as strict. Travelers can
el que pierda paga una bendición al otro. Requirements
by submitting photos of their favorite characters. An interval timer mode has also been added, making it easier for travelers to
capture the characters in the
part.
Me paga una suscripción.
Oh, I'm so excited
gane,
to see what all the master photographers are going to come up with.
Oh yeah, we'll also have the opportunity to meet up with Hosseini in Fontaine, and he's brought an upgraded energy amplifier
Jesús
with him.
Olivero.
Wait,
dice,
wasn't Hosseini studying energy amplifiers apuestas. In order to graduate? Oh. Does this mean that he still hasn't graduated? Oh no. Oh no!
Scientific research is filled with obstacles. This time, Hosseini has integrated the energy amplifier with Fontanian technology to create the Hosseini amplifier. And he'll need our help to test it out in combat.
Listen, if we can help him finally graduate, I am definitely in.
Yes, please.
No, totally. So, in each stage, travelers will need to form three parties to participate in three consecutive rounds of combat tests.
Okay.
Ah, ya lo hicimos, igual este evento está reciclado.
Based on their character level.
Black, cuando Motive llegues al final me gustaría platicar de ese tema.
Buffs in combat. The same character.
Déjame llegar al final, grabo lo que tenga que grabar y luego platicamos lo que quieran grabar, ¿vale?
Provide motive force in subsequent combat.
Porque tengo que dejar el material aquí para trabajar bastante.
While you're forming your teams.
Okay,
interesante.
I get it. So we need to make sure that each party has enough motive force to receive combat buffs. That way we can obtain a higher score.
Exactly. Once you've configured all the buff slots for a single party, you can also choose a buff to apply across all your parties. All
right.
Travelers will have to experiment to determine the best setup for them.
Awesome. Okay, is anyone else here excited about card
games? Vale, por fin llega Navia al...
I know that I'm excited about card games. So, in version 4.8, a couple of old friends are being added to Genius Invocation TCG. New
Errantes
monster cards
de...
and action cards will also be available.
Sweet.
Also, yeah. Overflowing Mastery event is returning in version 4.8, so don't miss out.
Let's go.
All right, that's all the event-related news that I have right now. So next, let's talk about system optimizations.
Wow, Sarah's on a roll today.
Thank you, thank you. Okay, first off, the encounter points system has been improved. In version 4.8, excess encounter points earned from daily activities can now be stored.
Oh.
Travelers won't have to worry about them going to waste anymore.
Ooh. Okay, so how do we use the points that we've stored?
Well, travelers can convert their long-term encounter points into daily encounter points by spending original resin. Long-term encounter points will be reset during every version update that ends with point zero. In other words, the first update for a new region. That means the first reset will occur in version 5.0.
Sweet.
Oh, nice. Mm-hmm. You can spend them immediately.
So cool.
Yeah, or you can save them for a rainy day. That gives travelers a lot more freedom.
Ooh, also, the cooldown for all world bosses will be reduced to 10 seconds.
Oh, yes.
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
I know. That should make it a lot easier to farm materials.
That works perfectly with the changes to the encounter point system. You'll be able to convert encounter points even...
Eso no lo entendí lo primero.
During every...
Eso sí lo entendí, esto no.
Let's talk about system optimizations.
A ver.
Wow, Sarah's on a roll today.
Thank you, thank you. Okay, first off, the encounter point system has been improved.
Punto
in version 4.8, excess encounter points earned from daily activities can now be stored.
Oh.
Travelers won't have to worry about them going to waste anymore.
Ooh. Okay, so how do we use the points that we've stored?
Well, travelers can convert their long-term encounter points into daily encounter points by spending original resin. Long-term encounter points will be reset during every version update that ends with point zero. In other words, the first update for a new region. That means the first reset will occur in version 5.0.
Sweet.
Oh, nice. Mm-hmm. You can spend them immediately. So cool. Yeah, or you can save them for a rainy day. That gives travelers a lot more freedom.
Ooh, also, the cooldown for all world bosses will be reduced to 10 seconds.
Ah, ya sé cuáles son los tiempos. Yes. Mm-hmm. Creo que son los de experiencia de región, ¿no?
To farm materials.
That works perfectly with the changes to the encounter point system. You'll be able to convert encounter points even faster now that cooldown periods are shorter. That's super convenient.
Oh, that's awesome. Well, we've also got new optimizations for travelers who love to follow the game's stories. We will now have a one-click, high UI feature, which will hopefully provide a more immersive experience. In addition, we'll be getting a new feature that allows travelers to review dialogue text and audio in their current conversation.
Básicamente,
so
Black, que ahora las diarias se harán solas. Esos puntos se ganan gastando resina. Y esos puntos te permiten canjear diarias.
Like
pero no voy a gastar resina en eso ni que tuviera choto.
Some domains in Mondstadt and Liyue will be adjusted. Travelers can choose to lower their world level once they've reached world level 3. The difficulty
Cristobal
of the
Gamer
license to glide quest
dice,
will also be lowered.
No mamón gastando resina en general.
Oh. Yes, that will be so helpful for new players.
Ah, sí, o sea, eso también entendí algo así. O sea, que gastar resina te da puntos de pericia, ¿no? Ya con eso haces las misiones. Es lo que me estás dando a entender, ¿no?
Well, we hit everything, right?
Actually, we still have some more information to share. But
ah, no, sí, sí, así no vale la pena, ¿no?
Play the final redemption code.
Primero ya hago mi diaria de volada.
Here we go.
Me gusta porque así al final de cuentas puedo llevar la cuenta secundaria y me va a dar tiempo para jugar el otro juego, el de
Cristobal Gamer.
El de, dice, ¿cómo se llama? El de.
Por eso te digo que las diarias se harán solas sin hacer nada XD.
Sí, como nosotros hacemos un chingo de. Gastamos un chingo de resina diario. Bueno, se viene lo bueno, chicos. Mira ese skin, weón. Se ve bonita, weón, pero está fea, weón. No mames, weón. ¿Cómo vas a comparar ese skin con esta, weón? Escucha. Chular skin, weón. No mames, está chichona. Esa vieja que no tiene chichi le pusieron chichi, weón. No mames, weón. Chichi, sombrero, weón. Parece el pinche zorro, weón. Mame, weón.
Welcome back, travelers.
En fin, vamos a ver qué nos tienen para el último. Este es lo que estaba yo esperando, weón.
Alright, let's get straight to the information that I promised.
Cristobal Gamer.
Uy, viajero, viajero.
Black Team Puro
XD. So cozy. I want to be there.
I know, right? Okay. Listen carefully, everyone. I have an important
announcement.
Hoyo Fest. Mm-hmm. Hoyo
dice,
Fest is coming
y dice
soon.
Que no le gusta los furros.
Oh, me gusta su traje, no el furro.
Hoyo Fest is an annual event ubicar. That celebrates all of Hoyo vs. games.
Oh, what? So not just Genshin Impact.
Tus gustos
oh,
es ver
exciting.
Las pezuñas
yeah.
de las furras.
Starting
la skin
July,
es la misma Navia, pero con patas de gata.
De hecho, sí me di cuenta que es la misma Navia.
By participating in these events, you'll have the chance XD. To obtain Hoyo Fest themed merch.
Es la misma de Navia, solo que sin bombacho. Es un, en la parte de abajo, más que nada, como un shortcito.
More detailed information will be posted across Genshin Impact. Oilo esa mamada, Chris
so stay tuned. So exciting. We also have an exciting collaboration to announce. Genshin Impact will be partnering with one of the largest aquariums in the mm-hmm. world, Sea Aquarium. Hopefully, travelers will be able to participate in an entirely new collaboration experience.
Oh, I don't think Genshin Impact has ever teamed up with an aquarium before. Let me think. It's got to be a Fontaine-themed collaboration, right?
Mm. Yes, you guessed it!
Nailed it!
This event will be based on Fontaine. Sijuin, the head nurse at the Fortress of Meripede, will guide travelers as they encounter marine creatures and explore the mysteries of the deep sea. Keep an eye on Genshin Impact's and Sea Aquarium's official accounts for more information.
Oh, I'm so ready. Fish time.
Awesome. Now for some out-of-game genius invocation TCG news.
Woo!
The knockout stages of Astra Carnival, the Prince Cup for the Atlantic, and Pacific regions will be held soon. The Atlantic stage will take place on July 27th, and the Pacific stage will be held on August 2nd.
So look forward to a fierce showdown between top players from those two regions.
Amazing!
There's also a little surprise in store for you all. Before the knockout stages begin, all travelers will receive a commemorative card back in their in-game mailbox.
Yes!
Let's go.
So be sure to follow the official Astra Carnival account for more information.
And that's not all. Genshin Impact's fourth commemorative OST album, The Shimmering Voyage Volume 4, will become available in version 4.8. It will feature original Genshin Impact music composed by the HoYoMix team.
Yay!
It includes tracks from version 4.8 events, cutscene music from versions 4.0 to 4.8, and other content. Oh, I'm so excited for
it! Music slaps!
Amazing!
I'm gonna listen to it forever.
All right, that's all the information that we have to share.
Then that means...
Yeah, it's almost that time again.
It's time for the special program to end?
Yeah.
Aww.
I know. Well, is there anything y'all want to say before we go?
Yes. I'm very excited for the costumes for Nilou and Kirara. They are so adorable, and I can't wait to see like their new roles that they get to play in this new event. I'm so excited for this. I can't wait.
I, too, as an unbiased individual, am excited about that.
¿Cuánto es el costo del skin, Chris, con el descuento? 1,200, ¿no?
I'm so down for all of this customization. And the music! Oh, it's so... Listen, I'm just very excited.
Y ya cuesta 1,300, ¿no?
Well, I just wanted to say, I'm so excited that you all get to finally meet Emily.
Yay!
I really hope you like her.
I know, totally. And I am super duper excited for HoYoFest.
And
also for the Sea Aquarium collaboration. That is so exciting.
Normal
and
cuesta 1,600,
I can't
wait
to see what happens with that.
So epic.
Yes. All right. Well, this is the end of the special program. Thank you all so much for being here. And yeah, I guess we'll see y'all in game.
Bye.
Okay.
Bye.
Bye.
Thank you.
Bye.
Thank you.
Bye.
Cristóbal Gamer dice. Si 1,600 a 1,650
creo. Calla, calla, calla. No mames, la mamá de ¿cómo se llama? De Sayu, güey, no mames. Esa mamada, vos. Mi taladro, güey. Está poca madre, güey. No toque taladro, pendejo, güey. Ok, la furrita está chida. Ok, la surfer. Está media morenita, media prieta.
Cristóbal Gamer dice: esos personajes me recordaron a Tower Fantasy, no sé por qué. El hexano.
Vale, está medio prietito, no tan prieto completamente.
Toma el foto al mapa de Natlán. Ufadidu.
Vale, ok.
Dice, ahora le gustan las loulis.
No, ¿sabes qué? Sí me llamó la atención, ¿o? Más que nada la chiquitita. No sé si se dieron cuenta. Bueno, aquí voy a terminar el video, chicos. Bueno, esa ha sido mi reacción sobre todo lo de Natlán. Espero que os haya gustado de la 4.8. ¿Qué me gustó y qué no me gustó? Bueno, me gustó la skin de Kirara. Los eventos son reciclados. F total, mal hecho, salvo uno que es el de un sombrero que se ve un evento ahí cagado. En cuanto al video de la región 4.8 del evento del mapa nuevo, GOT, está bien. Eso de la huella grande, pues bueno, es un misterio. Ya sabemos que prácticamente ya hay hasta seres interdimensionales en la mamada en Genshin, que es, hasta es la parte que no me gusta de mi hoyo a partir de que entramos a Fontaine. Se fue a la mierda la historia. Y fuera de ahí, bueno, lo de Natlán, los tres personajes están guapos, o sea, y realmente al final, si te pones a ver, tienen un diseño muy novedoso, ¿vale? Realmente les cambiaron el diseño, ¿vale?
Dice, me pareció más tecnológico de lo si que me esperaba, no Natlán.
Te pones a ver el principio donde va corriendo en el carrito.
La mamá de la Louli será la huella.
¿Vale? Me recordó mucho a Zenless Son Saga, chicos. No es por mamada, por mame, pero prácticamente tienen ese aire. Este cabrón es prácticamente...
Pero si siempre fueron interdimensionales.
Vale, sino entonces...
¿De dónde crees que vienen los viajeros?
Está bastante interesante. O sea, lo que sí, igual, eso que comenta Cristóbal es de que está muy avanzado hasta cierto punto el Natlan. Pero es que, chicos, tenemos que tomarlo en cuenta. Ya me lo esperaba. Yo no me esperaba un pueblito así con ropitas cagadas, ¿vale? Obviamente le iban a poner cierta cantidad de ropa. Lógico, ya lo vimos en Sumeru que pusieron cierta ropa, se supone que era selva, eran gente que vivía en la selva y en el desierto, no deberían tener tanta ropa y al final de cuentas tienen un chingo de ropa. Entonces, lo del vato, pues bueno, ok, lo de la tipa de que lleva un taladro de God, ¿vale? Lo más God de todo. Me dio risa. Y lo de la otra en el pescado, pues bueno.
Se viene un Mecha 3000.
Lo de la tipa en el pescado, pues bueno, supongo que han de ser los diferentes tipos elementales.
Para ser una ciudad de guerra y dragones, no parece, más bien parece Pokémon muy colorido.
Sí, de hecho parece Pokémon, ¿no? Tiene ese aire de Pokémon. La tipa carga una gorra, o sea, ¿qué pedo con la gorra? O sea, cuando vimos nosotros en la Edad Media, o en la Edad de Mesoamérica, una gorra, o sea...
Cristóbal Gamer.
¿Qué pedo?
Dice, la Louli seguro es Geo.
Sí, si ahí trae el pedazo, ¿no lo ves que ahí trae en el brazo el pedazo de Geo? Trae la visión ahí en la esquinita. Y ahora lo otro de que estén prietos, realmente yo esperaba un color más negro. Igual y son los primeros, ¿vale? Pero yo creo que ya esto nos están dando la idea de cómo van a ser.
Cristóbal Gamer.
O sea, es un poquito prietita. Dice, no es prieta, prieta. O sea, igual y yo creo que por la inclusión y la mamada no lo ponen moreno, lo cual me pone un poco triste, porque bueno, o sea, me representan a mi Ufadidu, pueblo, pero...
Dice.
Pero me lo representan güero con todo.
Se dice morenos, no prieto XD.
No, puede subir las paredes, no me había fijado. En fin, got. O sea, el carrito...
Jesús Olivero.
Carrito, dice, una mamada, güey.
Black, yo esperaba mamara, un papucho, man. Baja pantalenta y traen ese puchamón.
Vale, atrás hay una especie de dinosaurio. Ahora que me fijo aquí, hay como una especie de dinosaurio. O sea, que vamos a tener confirmado algunas especies de monstruos dinosaurios. En fin, ya veremos más que nos presentan en la siguiente, ya cuando nos presenten la 5.0 y lo que salga, más que nada de los leaks. Dentro de una semana, más o menos. En menos de una semana, yo creo, la gente ya va a estar alocada. Así que nada, nos vemos en la próxima, chicos, sobre todo para la reacción.
Si quieres, morenos, tienes...